It's your favorite podcast. It's Vanguard from y'all. The Reckoning with Reasoning. With your host, Legendary G. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to the 9th episode of Vanguard from Yard, The Reckoning with Reasoning. I just want to say thanks to all my subscribers. Thanks to all who like, comment, and share my content. Let's continue to grow this community. So, on this episode of Vanguard from Yard, I'll introduce you to Cashflow Neil, one of the CEO and producers of Cashflow Records, and also a presenter, broadcaster, and disc jockey at Edge 105 FM, live every Friday night from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m.
The global reggae and modern dancehall mix. You'll find it here. Outside Fridays on the Edge 105 FM with DJ Cashflow Neil.
Cashflow Records is operated by father and sons. Yes. Paul Father P. Mitchell and sons Cashflow Neil and DJ X, better known as Xtreme, founder of the Xtreme Arts, and that's the video production side of Cashflow Records. Cashflow Records started out professionally in 2005 with a song dubbed Pandicana, done by then group Soulja, which consists of Conscience and his late brother Delos. And little did we know that the song went number one in Japan, which also led to a tour in Japan. Cashflow continued the working formula, following up with It's From Conscience, This Year Me Have To Be The Winner, back in 2007, cementing their name in the industry as a force to be reckoned with. Then in 2009, Cashflow released The Crockett by giving us a hit song from Vibes Cartel, Look Pon The Life We Living, which went number one everywhere, followed by a plethora of hits from various artists. So I met Cashflow Neil while working as an entertainment producer at Irie FM, and instantly we became good friends. I also worked with Neil in a professional capacity as a songwriter and artist on a song I did with Kashima Francis, Songs of the Heart, which was the name of the entire project, which had Version and a few other artists. Also, my brother T-Bank's music video for Knight Rider was done by Xtreme Arts and the Cashflow family. So, without further ado, from the North Coast to Corville Gardens in Kingston, ladies and gentlemen, Cashflow Neil.
From the streets of Jamaica, come me live on the rec. DJ Neil, him the deal with mic check.
DJ Neil!
Yeah, watching a DJ Neil and everything, God, you know the boss tonight,
right? I'm blessed to love it tonight, I'm on Bushman, you got it locked to DJ Neil.
Yo, DJ Neil, this is Tony Curtis representing, and we are saying, I go out on the radio, man. How you going so bad, man?
Hey, watch out, DJ Neil, for real. Lava!
DJ Neil, put it on replay.
I'm telling you, keep it locked to DJ Neil.
Yeah, keep it locked to DJ Neil. Right.
Mr. DJ Neil, continue to play good music. Big up yourself, Sister Colondres.
This is Bobby Wine, aka Chagulanyi Sentamu with Cashflow Neil.
I know what Chagulanyi represent for Cashflow Neil.
Give me a cinema and answer about this thing they represent for DJ Neil.
DJ Neil! Yeah, conquer them from back of field. You don't know, never drop a shade.
Yo, how them feel? Them for no say a stylogy I represent for DJ Neil.
DJ Cashflow Neil, I want to them. You may know some we said the trend. Don't you say so.
Ladies and gentlemen.
So welcome, welcome, welcome to Vanguard from Yard, The Reckoning with Reasoning. And I'm here today with Cashflow Neil, producer, disc jockey, broadcast technician extraordinaire. This man is a talented individual, you know what I mean? So today we are going to talk about how Cashflow started to where it is now. So welcome,
Neil. First and foremost, blessings, the great legendary G. Thanks for having me, you know. Thanks for the invite. I'm grateful to be here, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Yes, man. Give thanks, man.
Just so you want to talk about the journey and everything?
Yes, man. We want to talk about how Cashflow started. And I mean, because, you know, Cashflow made an imprint and continue to make an imprint on the industry.
And you know, we're not gonna grow on that because you know, Clash Flow record, we live with spirit and make we feel like, yeah, you know what I mean? We love the production, we love right. everything.
Mega, yeah, make it give the journey. Oh, it all
give me the journey.
Yeah, man. So Clash Flow record is a music label. So it was founded by my dad, Father P, and of course him two son them, Clash Flow Neil, that's me, and Extreme, my brother. So it started out as a hobby, you know what I mean? And then we got professional in 2005. So we are look more like 16 years ago, you know, Clash Flow really got professionally in the music business as a music label. You know what I mean? But for Clash Flow Neil, people might remember me from East Trip Itlis, you know, CVM yes. with my co-host. Yeah. So yeah, but I see him 2005, you know what I mean? So
yeah.
I'm Hot 102 days on the radio, Friday night I play. Yeah, man. So the whole thing started out in 2005, 16 years ago. Clash Flow Records, yeah.
Whoa, man, is a senior citizen, man.
Yeah, man.
Yes, man. So yes, man. So you know, from them time till now, Clash Flow, you know, been doing him thing. You know what I mean? So what year did you get the big break, the first big break?
All right, the first big break. Well, mother say we never get our first big break locally. The first big break was actually in Japan. So me I talk about like same 2005. We started producing and we produced this song called Panda Kana. By a group named Soja. And that group is Conscience and Delos. At the time they call themselves Soja, Conscience and Delos. And record a song Panda Kana and it became a big hit in Japan. Metabo number one song in Japan. And so that song led to a tour. So we went on a tour over there in Japan. Me, Conscience and Delos threw away. Left Jamaica, gone over Japan. No management, nothing at all. Just threw away and we go over there. It was an experience to know said this song recorded right here in this studio right here, 2005, became a big hit in Japan. And then you know, we do the tour and dear things, man. The Japan people, they love that song there. And then we came back to Jamaica after the Japan tour and then we continued recording, producing. And then 2007 now, I got the big hit with Conscience Winner. This year, me have to be the winner.
Bad? So,
from 2005, straight back to 2007, continue producing. But the real big break at 2009, you know what I mean? That's when we got the rhythm, Better Life. So that rhythm features Vibes Cartel. Look on the life we live in. Conscience, keep bad mind out of me heart. Black Rhino, take control. G-Wiz, on and on. So that rhythm featured four artists. And 2009, remember that day, man, when me approach Vice Cartel and them time them up a Father Romy. I'm go up there, I'm sit down on the bench and say, yo, Cartel, me have a rhythm here and I'm going to hear it, you know. And me that, at the time, me have a CD with about seven rhythms on it. And me there wait and a bleach for him. I do a bag of dub plate and me say, yo, me move until Cartel hear at least one of them rhythms, you know. And so me say, yeah, play him say, all right, let me hear where you're going. Can you sit down there and wait how long? And go through some rhythm them and then when he reach a better life with him say yo see right this up and him say yo that rhythm yeah and same time him going to the boat and not nice him say turn on the mic not nice and start advice life living and from then 2009 big song can't forget that day so all is up a big up Vice Cartel for that you know what I mean
yeah man
so
big up Vice Cartel
come rhythm there and then remember the first time he played on radio I was at the university hospital. That was the day when my son just born. And me and my brethren in the care and yo, Liquid come on from the radio and say, yo, a brand new rhythm for drop from Clash Flow. Better Life rhythm. And we say, when the rhythm drop, man, I just some say, yeah, I hate this. Clash Flow bust.
Man, bust.
Man. Yeah, man.
Yes, you trust me, you. Trust me, you.
Exclusive interview again, right?
Exactly.
Before, man.
Are you all right? See there. Glad you said it.
Yeah,
man has a respect. Yes, man. Definitely. Yes, Fad. So talk to us about some of the hit song. I know you mentioned the cartel as a big bit, but talk to us about some of the hit song.
All right, all right. So, so with the 2009 now, with a big rhythm they know. So you know, say after that, we have to continue it. We have to continue it and keep the thing going. So me have a friend named Gary Freestyle. Them call him Wicked Foot, the Merc of a Sun City. And me and him in the studio one day, and me and him I say, yo, me know I acted, you know. And him say, yeah, make him forward at the studio, man. And him call up acting and acting forward at the studio, and then he make me meet acting, and me I reason with him and acting say, yo, that rhythm there way not happening, better life. Oh, never make it left me. He can't give me a piece of it. I said, no, acting. You know, so that's the first song we have put on the rhythm. I'm saying, here we're acting. We have a better rhythm than that.
Yeah.
And since my brother Extreme, because that Extreme Billy rhythm them, going on the computer and find one rhythm name, Give Thanks. And then acting, acting jump up same time in the booth and record a song name, Thank You Father, Thank You Father. Big song. That was the first song acting record for it. When he record a song there and record it and I mix it, the next day, me hear it on the radio. And then every diss jockey start playing. From that, me say, yeah, then acting every day, acting there at the studio. Literally every day as me wake up, I acting that me say, oh, I do at the studio. No. And then one day, me said, acting. Give a voice a ganja tune it. He said, no. But you know, me a go vice one do. I'm going to say, play that rhythm, the X. And that was the Orange Hill rhythm. Roll it up and puff it. And from that, history.
I just afloat.
And it was a bummer. Like, it was like a job. But then, like, you wake up, studio, work,
yes,
midnight. Yes. And then we have hits like all type of things them want, do. And then, like, every day. Now watch. Every just hits back at hits every day with us a record song, yes, as we go along, and the journey does continue. Yeah, man, just a lot of big songs.
I know a lot of big songs, and like you said, you know, all of them there are some classic yeah, things where still play up to today. Up to now, them still play. So you know, say them production, they're timeless. You know what I mean?
All right, so,
it's after it's, man. So talk to us about some of the entertainers now. Over the years, who you work with? You
everybody in an industry pass through this studio right now. Cash flow, where I'm at right now. Everybody can think of in an industry. Because remember back as 2010, when we in our peak time. So we'd have a rhythm named Bust Up Rhythm. Acting device on it first. Same say, me now watch no boy can romp with me like what they do with them catty. No, yeah. I fucked up with him.
I'm not enough, and not
remember with the voice that song there. And the next, as me say, as a voice, you know, the next day the song them a beat out for real, you know.
Yeah.
And then when I look outside, me see Charlie Black, me see Mataran, me see that entire week we complete the rhythm. About 20 artists for one rhythm. Cause them time they're juggling now, you can juggle the rhythm.
Yes.
So that was one of the biggest rhythm of all time. I mean, Bust Up Rhythm, man. We complete a project there 1 week. Like, we just have to say artists, just a turn up at the studio. Whoa. And we just a record, we just a mix, and we just have all our vibes and all our joy. And following up that, we have like RDX Catch.
Yes,
we have,
big sound.
Couple Spice. Well, if I it's, man. Yeah.
Yes, man. Most definitely. So, out of all that you've produced over the years, what are some of your most memorable achievements and proud moments? And they don't have to be like, no, extreme hitting on the numbers. You know, what are some of your proud moments where you say, yo, you know, you have to like humble yourself because you can't believe the love you have.
Well, we have to say like them awards here. I mean, the awards have been up in the studio.
Oh, you mean, man? Show them on the Vanguard, man.
Yeah, we have a couple of them on the wall, too. But we have to say, like, that project here, we named Pleasure Rhythm. Remember the camera. So, yes, since 2011.
All right.
So, this was a big rhythm. I mean, back in 2011. Denique Summer Love. Yeah, she was the big song on the rhythm. So if you remember Denique Summer Love, you'd remember the Pleasure.
If me remember,
all right.
Me sing that the song. Trust me, me sing that the song in a week, brethren.
Yeah, that was a big project. And the people in Africa love that rhythm there. We get a lot of feedback from it. And it's another award with Ayaktin again. Couple songs for them, man. Yeah, we have a couple awards on the wall. Yeah, School Bag Rhythm, Baby Sham Wine, Version in a Real Life, Sounds for the Heart Rhythm, featuring also on that rhythm, You Legendary G. Big production. Wally for Rhythm, man. Wally for things. Yeah.
Oh my god, cash flow. Trust the youth. It's like a university with the youth. I give you the information. And you know, being a fan of cash flow records from the time before me even meet you. You know? Yes, man. Before me even meet you, we know say, yo, cash flow. I've been telling you this, like the impact you can feel, the impact you can feel, the love in the street. It's like I can't wait till cash flow put out something because you don't know, say it's gonna be interesting, you know? Yeah, man. So bless up for that, man, and big up for that.
Thanks.
Yeah, man. So what are you currently promoting and working on currently?
All right, currently, we have a project out. It's called Dial Up Rhythm. So mostly I work with some new youths now. Cause I'm still like a new youth time right now. So under that rhythm, you have Decadan, you have a youth named Episode, you have a youth named Veteran, you have a youth named Run a Spanish Town, Temple Lyrical. So are them artists that depend on the rhythm, they're currently at that out for cash flow right now. But otherwise from that, we're currently working on a new studio. So the thing is, this new studio is going to be at Princeville in Canton Spring. So it won't longer be here at Cash Flow. So in Corville Gardens.
Corville,
Yeah, so it's still Cash Flow Records, but it will be more commercial at Princeville. Okay. So that's what we're currently working on now for 2022. So you know, it's still going to be new artists. So we are looking out for new talent, new sound, new artists. Yeah, so that are the aim for 2022 right now. Yeah,
and make sure the Vanguard get an exclusive tour of the new space.
The studio, 90% ready right now. So
yes, sir.
That's a new thing right now because over the years, Cashflow never really managed do bookings for artists. So we want to take it to that level right now where we can take up a new youth or a new talent and say, push it out that way. So that currently we're working on. Otherwise from that though, over the years I'm doing like a lot of mixing and mastering for overseas artists. Cause you know, true, we have all these big hits over the years to find out that a lot of people want to get the cash flow sound, the cash flow touch. Yeah. So we're doing a lot of mixing and mastering over the years, you know what I mean?
Yes, so that is a bad mixer. Okay, remember you mix some stuff away and trust me, I'm very impressed, you know. It's a bad mixer, you so trust me, thing up.
Yeah
man, most definitely. Who are some of the dancehall strong contenders currently, you would say?
All of the new youth, them, you know. Like, me like all them sound right now. Me like all them are doing them thing. So all of the youth, them right now, we have the buzz, have the stream as the number one trending right now are going. Yeah, man. Them are doing them thing, man. Them have a sound.
So what are your views on the industry, especially living with COVID, because you know how COVID affect the industry, you know, from 2020.
Yeah, well, but that's a good and bad still, you know, it positively and negatively. In the sense that where you see a lot of streaming going on during this time and the streaming numbers going up and you know, people over TikTok this and the social media, Instagram and you know, so that's a good thing in terms of we've seen a more visual. Now I mean, and the artists them get to be more creative too. They mean that them more, you know, through the COVID. So you find out a lot of albums putting out recently. Now I mean, and yeah, like the vibes are going. I mean, a lot of albums dropped since COVID.
Yes, man.
I want to tell you, and like how the Grammy looked too. Yeah, because the songs they were nominated for Grammy is quality.
Yes, man.
The Grams Morgan album, quality album. The Jesse Royal, well put together album. Man. I mean, Spice Duarte thing, well put together. Sean Paul himself. Now I mean, and the them Soldier, them do them thing too. Them nominated too. And now live out Itana put in some work.
And you know Itana mean? Been putting in some work.
Yes, because the last album she released with the producer sang on it too. So that was last year. You never get another Grammy thing this year, but Yeah, man. So some quality work I go on during COVID, and yeah, man, let them keep it up. Although we know COVID soon done, so you know.
Yes, man. Definitely bless up the reggae nominees, you know.
Yeah.
Big them up.
Definitely.
Respect and big up, you know. So talking about that, what you think about Massacre's new album?
Massacre new album. I want to give you a joke. Yesterday, me buy the album, you know. Like, me I leave from Ochi, come a town, and I tell the driver, I say, yo, driver, Bluetooth, you know, hook up the speaker, because I'm driving our bus, the sound system is all good. So we got some boomer, you know, we open the phone, and we say, all right, me we vibe to Massacre album, and we listen from start to end. I'm going to tell you, I'm going to big up Massacre. We had a competition back in 2010, where it was Become a Cashflow Star, where we team up with The Star and Gleaner, and Massacre was the winner. Yeah, and that time, the winner got a chance to get a Cashflow production, and he recorded a song on the School Bag Rhythm. That was the rhythm with Sham, Wine, featuring So Massacre, you know, we have that connection there for a long time, man. Massacre was the winner, and we're proud of him. We feel proud because we see from where I come from till now. And you can hear the maturity in my music.
And I'm craft overall.
We love the album, man. And not only that too, the production. I know we have music first, we have to listen to the quality and the production side of it. And you can see, I didn't get to see the credits for who do the production and the mixing and so forth. But to what me I hear, the production up there. Like, yeah, here, quality. And we need more of that in other business, because I only for ping-pong sound are going, and some young youth don't really want to take it on the professional levels and just do them thing. But with Massacre album, you hear production quality, and you hear real, real quality production.
Yeah, man, big up Massacre, man, and big up.
Yeah, man.
Big up Corey Tad, CM Speed, and big up Dunwell, you know what I mean?
Ah, Dunwell. That's the thing, man.
Yeah, man, big up Dunwell, man. So, last but not least, Cashflow.
Yeah.
What advice you would give to some young producers and practitioners who really want to take on the production journey?
Advice to the young youth, them. Boy, but I tell them, say, yo, work on your craft. I mean, like, not just just keep practicing, keep working. Like, we know it starts out as a hobby and you like it, but make it be professional level. If you have to even go school like me, though, CPTC, MTIR, or some other school or whatever, and get some more knowledge of it, try to do that. To how it sound right now, we not get the quality there out of dancehall right now, because everybody are doing it, but it just don't sound professional. And when I find myself doing for the past 2 years, me I listen to more Afrobeat. You introduced me to some Afrobeat song from back then, you know. I'm like, we kind of lost in this dancehall thing, you know what I mean? Because we not get that quality there. But me see, like, missing from the dancer right now with Afrobeat, when you listen to it, you hear like a live instrument, a live guitar, a live flute, a live trumpet, a live bass. You not get that in a dancehall right now. So you find out, say, some song bass too high, some song snare too high, and the whole dancehall thing just all over the place. So, but get that sound in the Afrobeat right now. So I think we need to find back that right now in a dancehall, because even with Cashflow back then, even when we talk about Pleasure Rhythm, I mean, that's a live guitar in the Pleasure Rhythm. Big up to Ducky, he attended Edna Manley at the time. So with Cashflow beats, we always try, even though we play the instrument them, and our Logix Pro and whatever, we still get a guitarist or a professional come overdub. So you still have the vibe and the energy, and then we don't find that now in a dancehall. So me that just advise you them, if you're going to music, just do it professionally and try learn to play an instrument. Try to learn the professional way and so that just do something and it sound good. Because right now, it not sound good.
Real talk, man. Straight up. I know nobody can answer nothing for that. You know, we need to get back to that space where we are creating
good quality music, good quality mic, good quality studio. Like,
exactly.
Yeah, you know, advice anyway. You know, sound hollow. Mixing the right. You know, spend the time to understand the plugin or it really work. You know what I mean?
Yes, man.
So we need to go back to the basic.
Well, cash flow, that's a good advice for the young youth, them, for the young producer them who are trying to come in at the game. And, you know, blessings again. And I want to thank you for joining me on this conversation. I know this is a short one, but this is the first. You know what I mean?
Big thanks, man.
You know, y'all is welcome to Vanguard, just like how me welcome to the cash flow family, just the same. So, you know,
nothing. Yeah, man, I love what you are doing with the YouTube together, because we're taking the interview with them, you know. Yeah, man, so.
Respect, man. Good, man.
And you reach out to the world, and yeah, man, we like that. Yes, and you keep the positive energy there. And
yeah, you know my energy. All right.
The energy from you just real, like, we always get a vibe from you.
Yes, man, enough respect, man. So I want you to big up your team still, you know. I want you to big up everybody's team before you go, you know. So
yeah, man, big up the entire cash flow family. I mean, big up all the members, them, you don't know. Big up my dad, Father P, big up my mommy, of course, because you don't know she, yes, a Neil at birth, you know what I mean? I love not my real name, but she loved the singer Neil Diamond. That's why she called me Neil. So yeah. I don't know. Right. Big up my son Kyle, because we are bringing him another thing. He calls himself Lightning. He's 12 years old. And
nice. I look forward to that.
We teach him how to play the piano. We are teaching him how to play the guitar. He have a song out named School Today. Check it out. It's on YouTube. And of course, I don't know. Big up to my daughter. She's 4 and she starts singing already. So, yeah, I big up wife to Sanya.
Yes, so, big up Sanya, man.
The whole cash flow team. Yeah, man. Big up. As for cash flow, Neil, you know, my thing, me in a radio, same way, as well as we try to balance the thing. So big up to the Edge 105 FM family and the Jamaica Observer family. I mean, I'm on, you can listen to me on radio every Friday night from 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock. So we just continue the legacy. What we there do from IRFM, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Yes, man, which is right. I'm a pro there, you know. I'm always pro there, you know that. So,
yeah, man, we continue the legacy, man. Producing,
yes, man.
This jockey. The whole works.
Well, cash flow, Neil. Manners and respect every time. And thanks for joining me on this conversation. See?
I will
definitely link, my bro.
Right, just big up all the subscribers. Likes, share. Right, go. You know the thing, you know.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe. You know?
All right.
Vanguard Fryard.
All right. Blessings.
Yes, man. Every time.